test. Bacteria, please all rise for the four-way test. Of the things we think, say, or do. First.
Is it true?
Second.
Is it fair or unfair?
Third.
Will the people well in their friendships?
Fourth.
Will they handle the world concern?
Please be seated. Rotary saw. PDF? Would you please? He has to sing Rotary song.
R-O-T-A-R-Y, trust them so very. R-O-T-A-R-Y is known and seen. From north to south, from east to west, he prophesies who serve the best. R-O-T-A-R-Y, the spell soldiery.
Thank you, PDA. Introduction of visiting Rotarians and unborn guests. Rotarian Irene, please.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. Today is my honor to our speaker, Professor Chen Yiqian. And today we have one guest, is Joy's friend Joanna. And welcome here again. We can see you next time and every time. And today we have the spouse, Sophia. The beautiful Sophia. And the Chloe. Thank you.
Thank you, Irene. Kristen's time.
Hi, everyone. This week, I would like to thank Tim to be our badminton team manager. And we finally start this Tuesday. And I think it's time for us to adapt the new normal, because you can see we all wear masks. And it's a bit more difficult than before, but I think we had a good start. So please, if you haven't signed up, then please come and join us. Thank you, it's my part of today. Thank you.
Second grace time. First is the strict following. Individuals, would you please introduce the strict following for us?
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. I was, I don't know, appointed by Anne or by Air to make a short introduction to 2021, for this year, 2022. We have in Chinese, 年度乌伦论坛. In English, should be Rotary Forum, something like this. It's a held. By the district, and I am this year's district Rotary Forum's chairperson, and my boss actually is Air. Air here, and well, a short story. When Air asked me to be the chair for this position, he told me, "Don't worry, you don't need to do anything for this year." But later on, the district governor training called me and said, "We want to hold a forum." Actually, in our club, we can have our own forum also. We not necessary to have speaker every week. Sometimes we can have so-called cross meeting and discussion some special topic. But discussion only, no voting, okay? For forum, for Rotary, we can open discussion, anything, but not necessary voting. So for this year, the topic is 如何有效增加新社友? How to have a new members development more effectiveness. And I want to highlight is the speaker is the TP computer of the Rotary Club of Taichung Da Tun Set. Computer is one of the, in that area. I was the sub-district Zhuli Zongjian, assistant governor 2002 and 2003. That was 19 years ago, right? And that year, computer, he was the president of the Da Tun Club. In that year, he developed, he introduced more than 10 new members, maybe 10, maybe 12. So that's a very high record for anyone Rotary member introduce a new member. And also very important, Da Tun Club used to be like just like most club have the membership that time about 50 to 60. But because of computers, PP computers promoting, and he continued, he then organized a committee in the Da Tun Club. So their membership growing so fast. And so now, Da Tun Club have over 100 membership and one of the largest club in Taiwan. So I introduced him to be the speaker. So the date will be October 18th, but afternoon is a Monday, and it's at Huanzhong Lu, at Rotarian Siemens, Rotarian Siemens place. But who should attend this activity? I believe all of you receive the email. If you watch, we do have this activity, and it's open to any Rotarian, free to register and participate. But the key focus should be for the current president, the president-elect, all the future club leaders, because you are most all club membership development. So for this is their focus members to participate. So today I just want to introduce you. The district sometimes will hold some activity that welcome you to attend. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. The juice. Sorry. Next. We receive invitation from RC Taichung Formosa, Taimei Fulenser, for global grant. Please contact Anne if you are willing to contribute for Harris Fellow to this project. The project name is Genomic Surveillance Laboratory at the National Institute of Health, Colombia. The next is, the board is to interview all the recommended candidates for Rotary Academic Scholarship on October 14th. Please ask your recommended students to submit company application documents by September 30th. Program, speaker introduction, MPP, listen.
Hello, thank you everyone. My honor to introduce today's speaker, Professor Chen Yiqian. Actually, because of the COVID-19, so we were previously, we booked a day to host the speech in last maybe May. Luckily, I have the chance, and right before the school start, we have been honored to invite Dr. Chen to join our meeting. And Dr. Chen is the JSD from Cornell. JSD is the PhD degree's name in Juris area. And her major is in woman's right. Anything to not men, not men's right is connected. And actually, according to this record, you can see Professor Chen previously is a lawyer, but now he dedicated in research area. We are all a colleague in the Judicial Reform Foundation, but actually, things I didn't really join the workshop or routine meeting usually. So the reason that I have the opportunity to know Dr. Chen is that we have the same hobby. We usually went to the same bar in Taipei, which is a trio. So, and later on, as you may know, that Chloe opened a sake shop, and likely Professor Chen also opened a bar in Taipei, Wanlong. Oh, it's called a book bar in Taipei. So welcome to join book bar in Taipei, Wanlong. So that's the, we share the same hobby. All right, next one. And next one? Oh yeah, okay. So Professor Chen now is the teacher in Shixin Dashi. I know our, Jimmy is the alumni, and her major is connected with women's rights, women's issue, and today we have the opportunity to know very special topic like sex, love, and the law, a glimpse into contemporary Taiwanese society. I think a real scholar can see the real problem in our society and really can share a workable perspective or solution to our society. To me, I think Professor Chen is the real scholar in Taiwan society. So I have the honor to brought you Professor Chen. Thank you.
Thank you for the introduction. Yes, we do have a strong connection.
Yes.
Love for wine and beautiful things. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for having me here. And I think I don't want to bore you with my feminist theories or other advocate projects. So today I will present you Sex, Love, and the Law, a glimpse into contemporary Taiwanese societies. So pay attention to the societies. I put it plural, because sometimes we wonder, right? Do we really live in the same society? Or actually we have very different sense of realities. Imagine if you have an international friend sitting here, and then he asked, or she asked, why in all the Asian countries you have Chai Ing-wen as a president? I mean, in a lot of Asian countries, we did already have the women leaders, but most of them, they were daughters of the politician or wife of the politician. Actually, international media, they are very interested in why. What is Taiwan? What did you do in the past? So in the long history of Taiwanese history, here in 2016, we have a women president, which is a remarkable success. And imagine, how are you going to answer that question? And imagine, I'm not here to debate about the capital punishment cases, but once a person who are on a death row right now in Taiwan, you know, next week, I don't know, you know, the government sometimes they are very, we cannot predict. Once this Mr. Zhen, let's call him Zhen, he killed his ex-wife and a male colleague of the wife, and he thinks maybe they were having an affair or something. So now he's sitting in jail and then sentenced to death. In a file, he wrote, "I really wanted to understand what love is." So he started to think, wow, if I really love this, truly love this person, why did I end up killing her? And then every day, right? Imagine if a father killed the mother, what would the children do? So it's a very sad story, but unfortunately it repeats itself every day in Taiwanese society. So imagine these two cases. Then I thought, okay, maybe if we just share this with you. So today I will first reveal myself a little bit. I will give you my personal story, my humble family, our parents. My parents, we were all born in Zhanghua. Actually, I come from Zhanghua County. I was born in Beidou. And my father was born in Tianzhou. My mother was born in Tianwei. So all there, you know. So first, I would like to raise the feminist questions. Why do I have all these thoughts? Why I didn't want to go to the other, continue to be a lawyer? Why do I concentrate in the gender and the law area? Then, let's talk about how do we understand sex, love, and law? We means we, Taiwanese, plural. From, and then I would like to argue, I think Taiwan is proceeding, transforming itself into constitutional democracy. And there's this one specific perspective about how we judge people from the standard of sexual morality to today. We can say, oh, Taiwan is actually one of the Asian countries where we are very proud of our gender equality success. And the last question is to you. I would like to argue, actually, in the recent 20 or 30 years, judicial branch in Taiwan are, by deciding many cases, actually we are doing something, maybe without any knowledge or consciousness, we are doing something in the West, in the Western European country or in the North American countries in the 60s, so-called sexual liberation. Let's see if you would agree with me. So, I gave a talk to the Taipei City government, and then, as you can see, Ke Wen-Zhe was there as well. Ke Wen-Zhe is a very difficult case for Taiwanese. But for people who live in Taipei, let's say. You just saw that, right? I work in an Awakening Foundation. Actually, before me, there were a couple of kind of established members of Awakening Foundation were sent to coach Ke Wen-Zhe. And I say, like, okay, you are right now the mayor, but at least you have to know a little bit how do we, you know, dress women, how do we, you know, show the media that actually you are, you know, educated and all that. But they failed. And I tried again. And I think I failed too. And yeah, I have evidence to show that, but it's okay, huh? Let's move on. So, my if I wanted to say relatively compare myself to the other feminist in Taiwan, I would say my curriculum. A special thing about my curriculum is not the degrees I have received from many universities. As you can see, I really love to stay in university. And Heidelberg, Cornell, Taiwan National Taiwan University. One thing in common is they have very beautiful campus. For me, I really love to be situated in a nice place, and then so we will have positive energy, and then you will think, wow, everything is possible. We can reform, we can do this, right? So, my father, besides those degrees, actually, I think my upbringing really gives me a chance to see Taiwanese society from a perspective. In my family, my parents, they met while they were teaching in elementary school. So they got married. They have two children, both girls. So now Taiwanese society would demand them to do what? After two girls. I think, yeah, get a boy. I think he is too young to understand this question.
Oh, sorry.
You know, it's not a joke. If you look at the statistic today, 2021, actually, okay, 2 years ago, 2020 or 19, you can still see the first newborn in the family, it's okay, you know. The ratio between the women, men against women, yes. In Taiwan, we used to be like 112. If we have 100 baby girls, then we will have much more male. But right now it's okay. The first newborn is okay. But once you proceed to the third newborn, then the ratio of the female to the male is too high. It's not normal. Okay. So in that time, yes, all the people say, oh, hey, you should try the third one. So then you can 传宗接代, as if me and my sister don't exist, you know, we cannot 传宗接代, right? But at that time, my mother, because of her excellent teachings, performance, she got a scholarship. Scholarship to come to Taipei. Remember, we live in Zhanghua. Back then, there is no Gaotie, right? So imagine, if you receive a scholarship, and your kids are 3 years old and 1 year and a half, and your husband is very sweet, but still, what would you do? 3 hours away, bus ride. Huh? What? What? Leave? Who would say leave? Marry. And then the children, I will be like, oh, why?
You will survive.
I will survive. Very good. So my father, neither my father or my mother, they say they are feminist. But I didn't right. But at that time, I think they come from a farming county and come from a farmer's family. So for them, this is not a gender equality issue. This is an issue of money, issue of social class. If you get the scholarship, you go ahead, go to Taipei and study, and then the rest of us will follow you next year. So my mother received the scholarship and then went to Shida. And then you know women, Taiwanese women, if you let them, they just run and run, and then you don't see them anymore, no. My mother got the PhD in chemistry, and then became a professor. So my father stayed as a junior high school teacher. And so most of my childhood, I remember my father took care of us, wash our hairs, and bathe us, and all that. So the whole family went to the 国父纪念馆 at that time to attend my mother's 大学, the ceremony, the graduation ceremony from the Shida University. So I wanted to ask you, is Taiwan a constitutional democracy? Back then, me, my little family, my parents, they made such a decision where it looks like it's against all the odds. 女人无才便是德, right? And marry a dog, follow a dog, right? At that time, it's not only a cultural saying, it's written into the law. So let us think about, like, for 1 second, what are the origins of the norms? What do you think this is right to do, or right to wrong, or wrong to do? When you think, okay, the woman received a scholarship, why is it a question? Why am I even raise that question to you? So in your generation, what do you think? If your wife, or let's just assume, right? I cannot assume people's sexual orientation, right? So if your female partner receive a better job chance overseas, what would you do?
Let her go?
With children or without children is okay, or depends? How? Both okay, right? Actually, it's a complicated question. Each family deal with the issues differently because each family, they have different supporting system. You know? Once I was speaking to doctors, the real doctors, not the doctors, the operating surgery doctors, and then one really old doctor said, oh, I would let her go. If she just deal with take care of the children, you know, it's okay, she can go, but take care of the children, you know? And then the other young doctor, I see the exactly of some young doctors there, right? Wow, as if children are not yours, right? So let's think about it. Do Taiwan really run by the rule of law or morality or religion? Do the customs actually guide your life, or actually more about economics factors? Like today, we are really blessed, right? I'm very grateful that I can be invited to here. You know, we are healthy and we can enjoy a big meal and all that. But what if right now we have to work for living in this pandemic is actually very difficult. Or maybe it's a combination of all the factors. And I couldn't help thinking, maybe in Taiwan, the most important standards right now, ruling the society, is not yet really the law. Or we should ask, where does the law come from? Who made them? This is just a period of communication I wanted to show you. I borrow it from the science of communication. That's why I strongly recommend it. Maybe next speaker could be from the oral communication department in Shixing. So when we talk about sex, love, is it a personal decision? Or actually, there's a lot of public information involved. When my parents, they decide who goes to Taipei to study, what's on their mind? How come we cannot be so confident like the youngsters? They say, okay, of course, scholarship, I take it, I go. Why at that time, in certain part of Taiwan or in certain historical moment of Taiwan, there are so much struggles going on. And here to show you that, you know, every night we will have a talk with ourselves, right? Or after the lunching, more than two people will go. This is like interpersonal communication. Like right now we are in this area, in this level, group communication, institutional, societal, institutional. For example, in the pandemic, CDC, they probably have meetings every day, right? Based on the most updated science evidence. And then societal, in 2 p.m., they will have the press conference to tell the society, to tell all the people what is the current status quo of the pandemic. So, how do we understand sex? Is it really personal? Or maybe all the norms hanging around in our society actually contributes to the reasons why we make such decisions. I was very impressed and a little bit sad after I hear a student's comment. Usually I have this class, right? Sex, love, and the law. And I will give them once like a blank sheet or use Slido, right? So you don't. When I receive the questions, I don't know who asked the question. There was one question that, dear teacher, right? I have a two-year-old relationship with my boyfriend, and he wants to have sex, but I don't think I'm ready. And my mom told me it's better not to have sex before the marriage, things like that. But look at my friends in Shixing, right? They are all happy and enjoy their, you know, adult life. What should I do? I'm not going to answer this question. Of course, then I will ask them to group themselves. For example, right now we can have 2 minutes and you can talk about this question and then answer the question. This happened 2 years ago, 2019. So, and then I feel a little bit sad is because, wow, I also, back then, many years ago, I was thinking about the same question. So Taiwan, does Taiwan change? Well, not really. We don't know, right? So, this is from Taipei Xiahai Chenghuang Miao. My temporary answer is, I think, what really rules Taiwan? Gong Miao Xitong. I really wish I could, you know, 打入 Gong Miao Xitong. Okay. This temple is actually known for kind of friendly for LGBT groups. So see, after the judicial interpretation in 2017, and then the whole society was discussing who can love who can register married. Is it only men and two women? How about two women or how about two men? They already say, oh, actually, Chen Huangye, it's the gods for judicial, you know, being to the judgment or to say like to pursue the justice. No, they welcome everyone. And 2020, here, they come, they kind of present the world this SOP, right? According to, where is it? According to your judgment, what do you think? The Cheng Huang Miao's SOP. People would say, wow, it's really good. All the Cheng Huang Miao, right now Gong Miao Xitong is really progressive. Or they would say, oh no, it's not fair. How come the same-sex partner has to ask the gods and then the heterosexual don't have to do it? It's not fair. But you say you are the protection god of the gods. What do you think? What's your prediction of Taiwanese society's response?
I have to admit, I really think that.
Really? And then what do you think? Like, right now they have the separate A, B, 雙軌制.
Well, it's more diverse in a way.
Right. So actually, there are actually some people say, wow, good for you. Because not every temple can accept that, right? But then my students, they were very angry. And actually one of my students, he is a 算信徒 吧, right? So he put it up there in the Facebook and then, and then express his anger. So I wanted to just point it that to you that, you know, it's all, we are all surrounded by all this cultural norms, concept, but we never really understand or we never really critically ask ourselves, questioning. For example, I mean, here I just pointed to you that through the judicial grand justice interpretation number such, the cultural concept, 爸爸说了算, right, was declared unconstitutional. But 什么叫爸爸说了算呢? The law says, if you have minors, you regarding minors a very important rights decision, if you cannot come to agreement, the father's opinions prevails. So that was the old law. Fortunately, it's already abolished. But imagine me, right? I come from a family where my parents, they kind of course they argue, but my mother actually is the dominant one. And my mother actually earned much more, right? But my father is very sweet, very good for caring children and all that. Then I went to National Taiwan University, I studied law. And then I realized, oh, what am I doing? Why do I want to participate in this unjust system? To study law, and then the law at that time was putting women as a second class. But good, right now we all did. No? I gave a talk in British school in Taipei, the European school, and then I have to talk with the parents and teachers. When Tsai Ing-wen became the president, actually there are a lot of discussion also, even till now, right? Women party, outside party, in the internet, you can see where. They call it 国安危机. They think women should go home, we should not sit here, we should go home and bear our children, but not run the nation. So we have to admit, it is still there, the concept, the idea that men should do such things and women should do such things, all these gender stereotypes are still there. And yet, we slowly come to a place where we think, okay, maybe we can do this, one case by case. And this is just a chart. I just wanted to show you that when we were at school, we were taught, there are two kinds of people, men and female, and that's it. Between men and female, they are yin yang, they are like human monsters, they are not normal. But it's not true. Right now, gender studies tell us there is a legal gender. Yes, there is female, male, and your biological sex, which is one definition of the sex. You are born female, you have to be act like a woman. And then your sexual orientation, you should love men. That's normal. The other is not normal, right? We once believe that gender, we kind of like collide the sex, gender, sexual orientation, gender identity, gender expression, and first name all together. You probably very it's probably very difficult for you to understand, to say, okay, if when you see me and then I say, oh, my name is Zhiming, right? Kind of people, even the first name has a female and a male orientation. But things are changing. This is my student's name. Can you believe, can you judge like who are girls and who are male? Who are girls and who are boys? It's very difficult, actually. But their parents are doing a very good job, because according to the gender studies in the US, if my resume, when I went to Cornell and Heidelberg, all that, if my resume stated in Li Xuanyi, then I will be doing much more than where I am. I mean, in the US, they put the same CV together and then put Zhang and Jane. And obviously, when you wanted to apply for a university, they all pick Zhang, not Jane, with the same qualification. So it has been proved. So I think right now the parents, they understand, you know, don't reveal too much about your femaleness or womanness. It would give you more chances to succeed. Let's just have a quick review. I think it's time is up. Huh? 1969, I was not even born yet. Huh? But imagine that the Taiwanese society with at that time, 不男不女的东西抓早的代为处理, not only they call you 不男不女, but if you just read carefully, it's actually just a musician who wear a male musician who wears long hair. That's it. Not even, yeah, very. And then the police officer would take them and bring them to the barber shop and they cut their hair. So this is 1969 Taiwan. And this is a 国小课本. I don't know if you have read this. This is 国语. It's meant for students to learn Chinese, not gender equality material, right? So 妈妈早起忙打扫，爸爸早起看书报. So then the NGO protested. Why father always reading newspaper? That's why we understand like man can be president, but this woman cannot never be the leader. This is our 国语课本,国文课本. So then they came with the second version. Guess second version, what would you change? So that we feel better.
Well, the father doing the breakfast, the mother go to the office.
Oh, okay, very good. So then we can, yeah. So the second version is 妈妈早起做早操. 然后爸爸还是继续看书包. Yeah, actually Taiwanese men are much more than just reading the news. You have to speak for yourself, you know? Feminists are not going to speak for yourself. You have to develop, explore yourself more, and then let the society know that actually you are not only that. Not only educated, but you can do much more. Okay, so this is gender. So we ask ourselves, where do we get the idea of how should people love, how should people have sex so that they will, the society will recognize them? I think besides the school curriculum, popular culture also is very important. This is 2014, way back, then, right? So, 世间情, 三立电视台 is a commercial TV station, but they are very responsive to the reality, right? So this, did anyone knows about this? Yeah. 是真的蛮傻狗血的, 是, this is the wife, the original wife, 大老婆, and then she felt like, oh, this woman would maybe have an affair with the husband. So then they two go together and close, become really close. They get to know each other. And then later they fell in love with each other, right? And then they walk away from the man who hurt them.
Oh my god.
真的很傻。 真的是有一点傻狗血。 But at the end they even have the same sex wedding. Right before the judicial yuan make the judgment. Okay, so men, as caretaker, how come we cannot understand or how come we cannot imagine in our culture, more and more men are taking care of the children, or at least share the whole the domestic affairs with their male partners and all that. But not enough, I think. We need more of this kind of images to change our conceptions about gender stereotypes. And this is when I was in Awakening Foundation. We have to do the fundraising, so it's very difficult. And I made a shirt. The point is the shirt. I didn't know that Tang Feng will be the 政务委员, right? So gender, female or male or me. If today I told you, oh, Professor Chen is a woman, what can you think about her, right? But how about just get to know her as a whole package? Gender is only one aspect of our life, not all of it, right? And so right now, actually, right now my project, my current project is to draft a law where we maybe provide the third legal gender as a category. Imagine Tang Feng Wei Yuan, everybody knows her, right? Because internationally, we are known to have a trans 政务委员. So we should really probably plus help us to, you know, receive the level of the international phrase and all that. Do you think she will go to the male toilet or the female toilet? Yes, very good. So you are updating very fast. So there is 性别友善厕所. But here in the hotel, I just checked, there is no gender. Actually, I think we try to change two places two in the building to make it gender friendly. Just like the toilet at home, right? At home, you want to go to the toilet, you go to the toilet, and they close the door, and that's it. Nobody will question you, are you male or female? So because of Tang Feng, we really know her, so she has no problem. But some of my students, they do have issues. They do have issues every day. So imagine here, if you feel thirsty, you drink, but they don't. They control the amount of water they drink because they don't want it to be contested every time when they go to the toilet. It's very difficult life. Okay, so how are we doing with the time? Huh? Okay, great. I do want to leave some room, time for you to comment or questions. So my argument is through the judicial interpretation, for example, on commercial sex, on same-sex marriage, on adultery, Taiwan is transforming. In the past, we believe in this sexual morality standard, right? We ultimately, our brain would judge this is a politician, the scholar, who have sex with the third party, the Xiao San, and then therefore he should resign, right? Then you ask yourself, why? I don't know their situation. I don't know how the couples are doing well, and I don't, who am I to judge, right? You can ask yourself this question. And now, this is a kind of like gender theories, right? It's done by American scholar in the cultural anthropology area. She argued, this is in the US, and I want us to ask ourselves, is it Taiwan the same? She said, according to her research in the US, there are good sex and bad sex. Good sex is happen within a marriage, without money, with heterosexual partners, and one-to-one numbers, and should happen indoors, and should be belong to the same generation. Yeah, this is very controversial, right? I mean, Chinese don't believe this, right? 同辈, and then it should lead us to the offspring. We don't do any meaningless sex. Okay. They. Let's just use the US as an example. And as Taiwanese, we need to do our own research. Is that true? This inner circle is good sex, but outside circle is bad sex.
So society actually has a very strong point of view, what is right, what is wrong, regarding your love, sex. And some of us meaning jurisdiction, we actually put it in our law and we wanted to apply it to everyone. But now Taiwan has approached an error through different judicial interpretation. We started to say, okay, if you wanted to punish commercial sex, then you should punish the whole team, you know? 就是嫖客跟小姐要一起啊, right? But all law would only punish 小姐. But you can say, oh, but men also, it could be a prostitute, yes, sex worker, but 90% more or more of women than the men are the sex workers. So gender equality rules apply there. And right now, actually the law changed to, oh, Taichung is actually, sorry, you always use Taichung as an example. Zhanghua also. Right now, the current law says, 专区内不法, 专区外法. It's up to each county, yourself, you self-govern. You think about 台中市民的民风如何, right? So then you can pass the law. If you say, okay, this is the red light district, then all the sex, commercial sex is not, it's fine, it's legal. Outside the area is not legal. So now it's all, the law is in your court. So let me ask you, in Taiwan, so many counties, which county has passed the law to allow commercial sex? None. Because if you ask 台中市, 他就说, oh, 我们民通淳朴. 然后你问云林, 大家都说, oh, 工商因为已经被废. 对, 对。So, 彰化县, right now I actually heard, I checked, only 彰化市还县, 彰化市好像已经, they propose a draft. So that's how we are, Taiwanese people, right? We know they exist, but we don't want you to face it. But the issue is the challenge is right there. So I welcome you and even more younger generation. You should learn from, you should take the lesson and learn from the older generation. Yeah, just be brave, do things the way you prefer. So, same-sex marriage, I think, is still very controversial. One of my colleagues, she married to a woman, so they are lesbian couples. They register married. Do you think she, I had this conversation with her, do you think she will dare to apply for the 婚嫁? What do you think? 世新大学, we have a gender studies institute. What do you think? Difficult, huh? Or it's okay. That's her right? And she can also not choose not to apply for it. Yeah, it's okay. I mean, it's her own decision, right? But this is not even a question for heterosexual couples. Of course, 婚嫁, I'm going to take it, right? So the law maybe provides already the rights, the basic rights, but the culture, the society is not yet ready. So she has to be sensitive to the atmosphere, no? To see if it's safe to come out. So a lot of people say, no, I don't think there are so many LGBT people in Taiwanese society. And I always respond, if you show friendliness or if you show your support, maybe they will come to you and invite you for a coffee or something, right? Okay, adultery, what, I think 2002, judicial interpretation say no, adultery law, it's constitution, but give Taiwan another 18 years. Now right now we say, okay, it's actually against the sexual autonomy. But unfortunately, the judge, the grand justice did not agree on the adultery itself is against gender equality. So that's my take right now. Thank you for listening, and I'm really appreciate if you can give me comments or questions. Thank you. And professions. Chen. And is there any question or feedback? Or PB still, please.
谢谢陈教授今天的分享。
所以我会觉得说大家要一起去思考这个问题，这样有回答到你的问题。那当然了，双方的阿公阿嬷、外婆都是请立帮忙。我小时候我爸去上课嘛，然后外婆来支援，外婆就说，就我听到外婆跟我爸说对不起，
因为他女儿去台北读书了。然后我那个时候心里想说，这有点奇怪，我难道不是爸爸的女儿吗？所以我小时候就是经常会有一些这种，嗯，这社会有点怪怪的。可是我当时当然没有词汇啊，所以我后来学习其实是宪法基本权利。我那时候去美国康奈尔念书的时候，那个 application 上面是写说我要研究环境法跟受刑人的基本权利，结果没想到去那边就修了一个 feminist jurisprudence 女性主义法学，就把我生活的记忆这些全部串起来。所以我博士论文处理的其实是男人跟妇女运动的关系，然后是在做育婴假，我们要怎么样比较合理的给他一个政策，让男人跟女人一样都可以享有亲密生活跟家庭生活，也可以兼顾工作跟家庭的机会。所以请大家理解，就是女性主义者并不是要来破坏世界和平的。
Thank you very much. I'm really interested in this kind of topic, and I hope we will have more time to discuss with Professor Chen. And I know I think our ultimate goal is to be world peace and non-binary. I mean, we have to respect every human being.Thank you. And we would like to give them a gift.
Attendance report. TV John, can we have the attendance report, please?
Good afternoon. Long time no see. And since Dr. Chen, it was a wonderful time. Thanks. Today, we have 24 members and 4 guests, and total.71%。71%。最后呢，我借这个机会，我也讲一个有关性有关的笑话。有一对夫妻哈，感情非常好。那久以后呢，因为男生女生都精力充沛，他每天晚上呢都如鱼得水啊，你侬我侬都非常愉快。那慢慢，这个太太呢，怀孕了，然后一段时间呢，肚子越来越大。有一天，医生就告诉这个太太说：“你肚子已经够大了，现在呢，不能再做爱了。”啊，结果呢，这老公因为精力很充沛，因为这样子呢，晚上就抑郁寡欢，食不出味道啊，很难过了。那这个老婆呢，也非常好，看到他那么可怜，那么黑，终于有一天告诉这个老公，你可以去找一个女人作为爱啊，我开放一次给你，但是有一个条件，你一定要找到良家妇女，你千万不能到风尘场所去呢，把风流病带到我们家来。哦，这个老公得了特喜就出门了，那出门呢，过了几个小时回来。哇，好开心啊呢，笑嘻嘻的回来，这老婆就很好奇说，你找到哪一位良家妇女？那老公就说，我们隔壁那个陈太太大学毕业，哇，那个风度又那么好，那么样，那气质又这么棒，所以我去找她帮忙，她就答应了。哇，然后她老婆就问她，你能给她多少钱？拿给他10000块钱，老婆听完好生气的一个巴掌打过去。上次她老公来找我，给我5000块，谢谢谢谢大家，谢谢。
Stop. Stop in the arms report. Yeah. because of time, so I can tell you a joke about that. From our president, Jimmy, thank Dr. Chen bringing us a very interesting talk. Look forward to having more discussion with Dr. Chen. Dr. Chen, may I tell you that our club is the first club that we have female members 25 years ago. Yi Taichung. And now still there are still many members, many clubs, they don't have female members. From IPP Essence, thanks for this great lecture. Both of them donation 1,020. Thank you.
What's coming? The regular meeting on September 23rd. President Jimmy had to invite Mr. Zhu, art performer, to be our guest speaker. All members and spouse are welcome to attend. Meeting adjourned. President Jimmy, please sound the closing bell.
I would like to introduce everyone to come to the regular meeting next week, because actually it's not from me, it's from Zhong Zhou's member trust, and he invited Mr. Zhu Zhu De Gang Xiangsheng Dashi from Hualien, and he will stay in Taichung for a week to give speech to almost every Rotary Club. So I think it will be very interesting. So hope to see you next week. Meeting adjourned.